Hi everyone, my name is Ahmed Yassin. I'm working in the Cloud Identity Authentication team. Today we are going to show you how you can configure and enforce Azure Multi-Factor Authentication and secure your authentications. Let's start. Multi-factor authentication is a sign-in process where a user is prompted for additional forms of identification, such as a code sent to their cell phone or a fingerprint scan on their device. A user is generally presented with such prompts the first time that they log in. There are multiple ways MFA can be triggered for multiple login scenarios. Today, I will explain the common ways to enable MFA to help you choose the best option for your environments. Azure MFA can be forced in multiple ways: through conditional access policy, through security defaults, by instituting per-user MFA, through Azure Identity Protection. I will now explain each of these scenarios. Enabling MFA through conditional access policy. Conditional access controls allow admins to decide when MFA is required for the users in their tenant. For example, they can require MFA for specific cloud applications, users, or locations. You need an Azure AD Premium license in order to be able to use conditional access. Also, other licenses may cover it, like Azure Premium P2. Let's look at an example. Open your Azure Active Directory blade, then go to Security option. From there, you should find the Conditional Access blade. Click on it, and then click New Policy. As we can see, Conditional Access policy include a lot of configurations which give you a flexibility to choose when to trigger MFA. For example, we can choose subset of users or groups. Targeting a specific cloud apps, like if you just want to enable MFA for Exchange Online because it contains a sensitive data. After you configure all the requirements, click on Grant under Access Control and select Require Multi-Factor Authentication. This means that MFA will be triggered for the selected users, groups, apps, or conditions. Enabling MFA through security defaults. Security defaults in Azure Active Directory make it easy to secure your organization with a pre-configured security setting for common attacks. They are available to everyone and are enabled in the Azure portal. Using security default means that all users in your tenant must register for multi-factor authentication in the form of the Azure Multi-Factor Authentication Service. Users have 14 days to register for multi-factor authentication by using the Microsoft Authenticator app. After the 14 days have passed, the users will not be able to sign in until multi-factor authentication registration is finished. We understand that some users might be out of office or will not sign in during the 14 days immediately after enabling security defaults. To ensure that every user has ample time to register for multi-factor authentication, the 14-day period is unique for each user. A user's 14-day period begins after their first successful interactive sign-in after you enable security defaults. In order to enable security defaults across your tenant, sign in to the Azure portal as a security administrator, conditional access administrator, or global administrator. Browse to Azure Active Directory. Then click on Properties. Select Manage Security Defaults. Set the Enable Security Defaults toggle to Yes. Now select Save. If you want to disable security defaults at any time, just toggle Enable Security Defaults option to No. Remember that this does not require any special license. It comes with the Azure AD Basic Free version. Enabling MFA per user. You can also enable MFA on a per-user basis. This configuration means that MFA will be triggered whenever the user accesses any cloud service. Admins have only one option to bypass MFA from specific IPs by whitelisting them. This method provides limited option to customize the MFA process. This MFA service comes with Office 365 version, such as Office 365 E3 and E5 license. You can learn more by going to aka.ms/MFA license. Let's go through this configuration quickly. Open Azure Active Directory blade, then click on Users blade, and then click on Multi-Factor Authentication option. From the first blade, you can check the status of per user MFA for any user. If you need to enable any user for MFA, just click on it and click on Enable option. The user will now be asked to complete the MFA process whenever they access a cloud service. From the same page, if you go to Service Settings, you will find some options that may help you to bypass the MFA from specific IPs or from intranet. Enabling MFA through Azure Identity Protection. Finally, you can also enable MFA through Azure Identity Protection. Identity Protection is a tool that allows organizations to accomplish three key tasks. Automate the detection and remediation of identity-based risks. Investigate risks using data in the portal. Export risk detection data to third-party utilities for further analysis. Azure Identity Protection requires Azure AD P2 license, which will also cover the MFA license. An admin can configure their identity protection in a way that will trigger MFA in case of risky sign-in attempts. This can be done by configuring the sign-in risk policy. In this scenario, if identity protection detects a risky sign-in, it may trigger MFA in order to make sure that the account is not compromised. Let's take a look in how we can enable this policy. Browse to Azure Active Directory Blade. Then click on Security. Choose Identity Protection. Then click on Sign-in Risk Policy. Under Assignments, choose all users or select individuals and groups if you are limiting your rollout. Optionally, you can choose to exclude users from the policy. Under Sign-in Risk, Microsoft recommendation is to set this option to medium and above. Click on Access. Microsoft recommendation is to allow access and require multi-factor authentication. Set Enforce Policy to On. Click Save. Finally, there are several other situations that may trigger MFA, such as requiring MFA for device registration in your tenant device settings, to complete self-service password reset, pair request by the application, such as a federation IDP like ADFS, requiring MFA to be performed. So this leads to the question, how can admins track these MFA requirements and know the source of MFA triggers? Azure AD provides the sign-ins blade, which can give more details about the user sign-in. Every time a user accesses any cloud service, a sign-in record will be created. This sign-in can give more details about the sign-in. Now you know how to enforce MFA in your organization's authentication requests, as well as how to track and review these attempts. To review more on what we discussed here and deployment considerations, please visit aka.ms/deploy MFA.